unwavering faith and compassion have made her a beacon of hope to many, but not all who surround her have pure intentions. Hidden beneath smiles and seemingly supportive words lie deceitful hearts, those who pose as friends but are secretly enemies. In every believer's journey, there lies a paradoxical challenge, those who wear the guise of friends but harbor the intent of foes.
Rose, you called me. I hope all is well. I was in the middle of a very important meeting.
Maria, my mom's surgery is tomorrow. We are yet to raise the money for the surgery. Maria, you are my last hope. Do not let my mother die. If she die, I'll die.
You won't die, Rose, and your mom won't die. What are we going to do now?
Maria, I beg you in the name of God. You know you are the only one that can help me. I am your only friend. Pity me, do not let my mom die. Maria, have mercy please.
Rose, I just got paid today. I intend to get some groceries for my mom and also get some for myself. But, your mom's health is at stake here. I'll send you the money for that so that the surgery can commence. Do not worry, mom will be fine.
Thank you so much, Maria. God bless you. I knew you are the only one that can help me. God bless you.
All thanks be to God. I'll call mom once the surgery is over.
Do not worry, she'll be the one to call herself. Let me start going now.
I'll make the transfer as soon as possible.
How did it go? Why are you laughing? I just asked a question.
Didn't I tell you that Maria is such a fool? She promised to give me the money without thinking twice. I fooled her. She thought my mom is still in the hospital. My mom only had diarrhea and she's fine now. She said she'll transfer the money to me as soon as possible. In fact, she just got paid. Yes, I am some thousands richer. Maria's loss.
Wow. This lady is really a fool. What kind of stupid heart does she have? Giving anyhow. That's why I hate her so much.
Don't just sit here and rant, go in there and collect your own share from her. Cook up something. Tell her that you haven't eaten or you need to clear your goods. We need to drain her.
Yes. We need to drain her. Let's give her 2 hours.
Sharon. I didn't know you were coming. Sharon, why are you looking sad? What is the problem?
Maria, I haven't eaten for 3 days now. I spent all on me for my goods to be shipped into the country. Now, I was called to pay extra fees. I don't have a dime on me. Where do I go, Maria? Who do I turn to? My hope is dashed. I am helpless. Maria, I am about to commit suicide.
Suicide is not an option, Sharon. God will surely solve this problem. I'll assist in any way I can. Although, I don't have much on me either, but God will provide. Send me your details. And please, let me get you something to eat. Go to the cafeteria, I'll meet you soon.
I am ashamed of myself. Thank you so much, dear friend. God bless you and protect you. I am so happy.
Hello, is Miss Maria your friend?
Yes, she is. Any problem?
No problem at all. Just to tell you that you are so lucky to have her as friend. She is very kind and jovial. She has helped everyone that has come across her way. She's beautiful and intelligent too. I'll keep praying for her. Thank God, she just got promoted again. I'm so happy.
Here we go again. Did you just say she got promoted?
Yes, we are all excited.
When?
Today. You don't look excited.
Who told you that? I am very excited. Thank you, Jesus.
That's good. I'll leave now.
Sharon, what happened? Did she turn you down?
Madam Kindness will never say no to kindness. Only God knows how she keeps getting more money. She gave me the money already. But guess what? This evil lady got promoted again. The last one was barely 6 months.
Promotion again? That's more money for her. This lady is a witch.
The annoying thing is that people praise her every day. It annoys me. Why am I not been praised? She's liked everywhere. She's the most favored amongst us. We went to the same college and university. She graduated with good grades and she's loved everywhere she goes. But, what about us?
I can't take this again. First, the man I was supposed to be with shows her over me. She literally took everything that was meant to be mine. Her cup is full. I'll revenge. In fact, I want to punish her.
Rose, we are in this together. I hate her with passion. This will be her end.
We'll deal with her.
I saw you earlier. Why did you invite me here?
Yes. I called you here for business. And I am willing to pay you any amount to get this done.
Business? Let's hear it.
I want you to implicate Maria at work. I want her sacked. I will pay you any amount you request for. Do not shout.
Ma'am, I am sorry. I can't do that.
You think I am joking? I will pay you.
Do you think I am joking too? I can't do it.
Then, you will keep this a secret between us. If you spill it out, you're dead.
Are you threatening me? I promise not to tell anyone.
Better.
Please come in.
Good morning, sir. I got to my desk this morning and I saw the written letter and the mail sent to me by the board. It says that I have been suspended temporarily.
Look, Maria, I didn't decide that. The board did.
But, what is my offense? What have I done?
As the managing director of this company, you have no right whatsoever to stand there and be questioning me about your suspension. If you need any clarification, respond to the mail. I believe I deserve some respect from you. Please, get out of my office.
Mission accomplished. I am so sorry about what happened, Maria. You were too nice to get this kind of punishment. Do not worry, God will do a better one.
A better one? It is just a temporary suspension. Do you want me to get sacked?
Not at all.
Maria, I am sorry about what happened to you. I decided to come here immediately I heard it.
Rose, how did you hear? It is what?
The securities told me. I wanted to come and thank you for the other day, and the securities told me.
Oh.
Maria. What is wrong with you?
I have been having chest pain since the incident. I think I need to go to the hospital. Can you drive me, please?
Of course, I will.
Miss, the result of the test carrier out on you revealed that you are HIV positive, and it is advancing towards AIDS. HIV attacks the immune system, and if left untreated, can lead to AIDS, where the body becomes severely immunocompromised and vulnerable to opportunistic infections and certain cancers. This progression is life-threatening and underscores the critical importance of early detection, treatment, and prevention of HIV. You are already advancing towards AIDS.
My goodness! This is not possible, Doctor. It isn't possible. How? No! Doctor, I'll repeat this test.
Miss, we have the best lab scientists in our hospital. If you go to any other hospital, this is what you'll get. What we need to discuss now is the treatment plan.
No, Doctor.
Maria, how did you do it?
You of all people know that I won't have any sort of intimate relationship with any man till marriage. I don't know how I came in contact with this. How will Arthur feel? He's ought to come back to the country tonight.
Wow, he's coming back? That's a great news.
Why are you this excited?
Nothing, dear. What are we going to tell him now? Let me have his contact. I'll try and speak with him.
Thank you so much, Rose. Thanks for being a good friend.
Anything for you, Maria.
Rose, you know I shouldn't be here with you. Why do you insist we meet here?
Arthur, Maria has been frolicking around with men and now, she's HIV positive. I've sent the test result to your phone. You chose her over me. You deserve this. The truth is, she doesn't want to see you at all. It is best you stay far away from her for now. I came to tell you because, even if I can't be with you, you don't deserve to be infected.
Maria would never do that. Why is she sending you, of all people, to me? I don't trust this at all.
Why? Is the test result lying too? Her name and details are there. That's a top hospital in this city. They can't lie.
Please, take your leave immediately. I need to think.
Please, think, Will.
What did he say?
I tried to explain to him, but he was really angry. He chased me out. He told me to tell you never to call him again, and if you do, he'll have you arrested. He threatened to arrest me when I kept on begging him. He called us names. I had to leave when he wouldn't listen. Maria, I think you should let that guy be for now. He doesn't want you again. I'll take my leave now.
Thank you, Rose. I am grateful. Heavenly Father, I come before you with a heart heavy with pain and confusion. Lord, I feel crushed by the weight of my struggles. First, I was suspended at work, then diagnosed with HIV, and now my fiancé has left me. I feel so alone and broken. Father, I cry out to you, asking for your mercy and understanding. Please reveal to me the source of these trials. Show me why I am facing such torment. Help me see if there is something I need to learn or change. Grant me the strength to endure and the wisdom to understand. Lord, I place my trust in you, even in this darkness. Please guide me, heal my wounds, and restore my hope. I believe you have a plan for me, even though I can't see it now. Hold me in your loving arms and lead me through this valley of pain. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Did you really think we'd let you succeed? We couldn't stand to see you happy and thriving while we struggled.
We made sure to ruin everything for you. We whispered lies about you at work, and we even found a way to infect you. Your fiancé? He was easy to manipulate against you.
You deserve every bit of suffering you're going through. We won't stop until you are completely broken.
You're alone now, and that's exactly how we wanted it. No one will believe you, and no one will help you. This is just the beginning of your downfall.
My goodness. What have I done wrong?
Because you are too blessed and you are too kind.
So, I was dreaming. This dream isn't ordinary. I don't believe it. Rose and Sharon can never do me evil. Not after everything we've been through together. No, it can't happen. It is not possible. I'll just leave everything to God to fight for me. I don't want to believe this. The time is 3 a.m. This isn't ordinary. I need to embark on 3 days fasting and prayer. God must settle me and fight my battle. Linda, thanks for visiting me. How's everyone at the company doing?
They are fine, ma'am. And how's your health now? I heard what happened.
What happened?
The HIV, ma'am.
My goodness. How? How did you know?
Your friends, ma'am. This is exactly why I'm here.
My friends? Which of them?
One is Rose and the other is Sharon. They wrote to the company that you'll no longer be working with the company again as you've just been diagnosed with HIV/AIDS and you decided to stay far away because you don't want to infect others. I didn't believe it, not until I saw the test result attached. But, I was still convinced that your friends have ulterior motive. The other day, the one that bears Sharon invited me and told me she would give me any amount if only I can implicate you at work. She told me to ask anything and she would provide it. I refused her offer. But I guess she called Ernesto. Ernesto agreed to their offer and also liaised with the MD. The MD was the one that got you suspended. He envies you a lot and he's scared you might take his position because you keep getting promoted. Ma'am, they threatened to kill me if tell you anything. But these past days, I couldn't keep it again. I had to come.
My goodness! Is it a crime to be getting blessed or to be kind? What is all these?
The good news is that, Ernesto himself went to confess to the CEO about the situation, they've both been sacked. He went to confess yesterday and he's been sacked. The board will reach out to you soon. Are you really sure you are HIV positive? Are you sure it is your result?
I beg you in the name of God, ma'am. It was the devil at work. Forgive me, please. Do not allow the police to take me away. I promise you, I'll never do that again.
Because of money, you forged fake result for me. You put me in a confused state for over 1 week. You made everyone run away from me. You made me lose my relationship. You caused me pain. You couldn't even respect your profession. This will serve as a lesson to all the people that does this. You are so heartless and mean. So, I wasn't positive all these while, but you tormented me mentally, physically and emotionally. I felt like dying even while there was no death.
You a Christian, ma'am. Forgive me for Christ's sake.
It is funny how you evildoers insert the name of God when you have been exposed. Why didn't you think of God when you wanted to kill me? You deserve everything that comes your way. Well, I am not the one arresting you. Your hospital is the one arresting you for this.
You can plead on my behalf, ma.
Why are people so wicked? After being nice and kind, they still hate you for being nice. I need to do something about this.
Dear Maria, I received your message and my heart aches for the pain you are enduring. The Lord has shown me the betrayal and the malice that your friends have inflicted upon you. It is a heavy burden to bear, but take heart, for God is with you and will guide you through this trial. First, it is important to understand that while you may feel the urge to take matters into your own hands, true justice and healing come from the Lord. Psalm 55, 22 says, "Cast your cares on the Lord and he will sustain you, he will never let the righteous be shaken." Lay your burdens before him, for he will support you and bring you through this dark valley. Dealing with friendly enemies is especially challenging because their betrayal cuts deep. Jesus teaches us in Matthew 5:44, "But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you." While this may seem impossible, praying for your enemies will release you from the bondage of bitterness and allow God to work in both their hearts and yours. Moreover, Romans 12:19 reminds us, "Do not take revenge, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath, for it is written, 'It is mine to avenge, I will repay,' says the Lord." Trust that God sees all and will act in his perfect time. Vengeance belongs to him, and he will ensure justice is served. Seek God's guidance in how to protect yourself from further harm. Proverbs 27, 12 advises, the prudent see danger and take refuge, but the simple keep going and pay the penalty. Be wise in your dealings with these friends, distance yourself if necessary, and surround yourself with those who uplift and support you. Finally, remember Ephesians 6:10-11, finally, be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Put on the full armor of God, so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. Clothe yourself in His righteousness, truth, and peace, and stand firm against the enemy's attacks. Maria, God is your refuge and strength. He will fight for you and bring healing and restoration. Hold fast to your faith and allow His love to guide you through this storm. God bless you, Maria.
Amen, ma'am. I just find it so painful. I'll take to your advice, ma'am. God bless you too.
Let's pray.
I knew they were all lies. I know you couldn't do such. I was only scared, confused and frustrated. I wanted to give it time before coming to meet you. And now this? Thank God I came here today. Those friends of yours are devils first and second born. They are the devil themselves. How can they be so wicked?
Thanks for coming back. I was scared to call you. I thought you were really angry at me. Not knowing she lied to me and she lied to you. Let's forget about it, Arthur. Good news. The board has given me double promotion. I am to resume as the new MD next week, Monday. God is so good.
Wow. Great news. We need to celebrate this.
I am so happy. Sharon, God sees my heart. I have forgiven you too. I have already handed everything over to God.
You've been so kind to us. Rose can't even face you. Please, dear, it is the devil. Forgive us for Christ's sake. You know, I beg you. I want us to continue our relationship like it used to be. Let's forget all that has happened. Let's embrace love. Maria, let's be one.
Sharon, if you were to be Maria, and I were to be you, would you trust me again after all of these? I mean, would you still want a cordial relationship with me?
May. Be.
Sharon, I have forgiven you and that's all that matter. You can take your leave now. I need to do some things.
Ah. I have never been this humiliated in my life before. I was so ashamed of myself.
It serves you right. I was never going to apologize. I hate that girl with passion. You were the one that's scared of her retaliating. She can do nothing. She's too compassionate to retaliate. Look, I'll stop at nothing to bring her down.
You see this she has done, by not even considering that I came to beg her, she must die. I wish there's a spell I can cast on her so that she'll just die.
You just said the right thing. Now, I have made my research. There's a witch doctor somewhere. I have the address. We'll go there now and make sure we finish her. She won't be able to have that managerial role, her fiancé and other things. Either she run mad or she does.
We shouldn't delay. Let's go immediately.
Play something nice. This is going to be the end of Maria. I can't wait to see her downfall.
I am so happy. How can one person have it all in life?
Very good job, good man, loved by everyone, kind, rich and pretty. So annoying.
Do not worry, let's dance away our sorrow.
This morning, a tragic motor accident occurred along Greenfield Avenue involving a blue Toyota Camry with the plate number Z1234. The vehicle veered off the road and caught fire upon impact. Emergency responders arrived swiftly at the scene and managed to retrieve two bodies from the wreckage, both burned beyond recognition. The remains have been transferred to St. Mary's Hospital for further examination and identification. Authorities are investigating the cause of the accident and urge all drivers to exercise extreme caution and adhere to traffic regulations. Please drive safely and remain vigilant to prevent such devastating incidents.
My goodness. That was Sharon's car. Ah!